गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 8। नाउ टुडे इन चैप्टर 4 वी विल कंटिन्यू दिस चैप्टर 4 एटॉमिक स्ट्रक्चर हियर इन पेज नंबर 46। टुडे वी शैल स्टडी विथ वैलेंस सेल, वैलेंस इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड वैलेंसी। What is valence cell? Suppose this one is sodium. What is its atomic number? 11. What will be configuration? 281. So, one will be in the outermost cell. This outermost cell is your valence cell. So, what is valence cell? The outermost cell is called valence cell. Now, if it is sodium, what is the number of electrons present in the valence cell? Obviously, 1. So, 1 will be the valence electron. Then what is valence electron? The electron present in the outermost cell is called valence electron. Then, here are 3 cells. Not from this end. Just before the outermost cell, just before outermost cell is this one having 8 electrons. So, just before outermost cell is called penultimate cell. If we have calcium, atomic number is 20, its configuration is 2882. So, since it has cell number 1, cell number 2, cell number 3, cell number 4. This cell number 4 or KLMN, 4 or N cell is your valence cell, and this KLN, third cell, is your penultimate cell. Then, what is valency? We have studied that the electrons donated or accepted or shared is its valency. So, what is valency? Valency, it is the combining capacity of an atom. How many electrons it can donate or accept or share. So, valence cell, the outermost cell of an atom is known as your valence cell or valence orbit. Valence electron, the electron present in the outermost cell, valence cell, is called valence electron. So, the number of electrons varies from 1 to 8 for the atoms of different elements. Means valence of electron of an atom determines the valency, means how much it can gain or share. If we say what it is saying, valence electron varies from 1 to 8. If you will know those things, those homeworks are when you will come to know. I had given you this page number 48. I have told you, my dear students, this is 48, page number 48. Try to get by heart these things. Like sodium, it has one valence electron. Magnesium, calcium, it has two valence electrons. Aluminium, it has 3. Carbon, silicon, it has 4 valence electrons. Nitrogen, phosphorus, it has 5 valence electrons. Oxygen and sulfur have 6 valence electron, and fluorine, chlorine, bromine, they have 7 electrons in the outermost cell, and all the inert gases except helium, they all have 8 valence electrons. So, the valence electron varies from 1 to 8. Here are the, these are not the picture of flowers, but it is the picture, it is a diagram of electronic configuration, how the electrons are arranged. For example, this one is your hydrogen. It has atomic number is 1. So there will be only one electron in the first shell. Now if it is helium, have two electrons, so it have two electrons. Then it is lithium. Atomic number is 3. In first cell there will be 2 electrons, in the second cell 1, and so likewise. We should know these things. I have told you, get these things by heart. Now, how do atoms combine? How do the atoms combine? Atoms combine to form molecules. The main tendency, main purpose of an atom is to form the molecules. And why molecules? To form molecules, to get chemical stability, because they have incomplete cell. Now what does it mean? If you see the inert gases except helium, which has 2 electrons in the outermost shell, whether it is neon, argon, krypton, xenon or radon, they all have 8 electrons in the outermost shell. They all have 8 electrons in the outermost shell. And now they are inert. We have studied that no outermost shell can have more than 8 electrons. So if they have 8 electrons, they are inactive. They are inactive or they do not react. So they are called inert gas, noble gas or rare gases. And if this is called octet law. And if an element has only one cell and it contains 2 electrons, means number, if this cell is filled, it is also inert. So these have complete outermost cell. But if you say any elements, for example, hydrogen, atomic number is 2 and it has only one electron, even the first cell is not complete. Oxygen, atomic number is 8. Configuration is 2-6. There should be 8 electrons. Still, it is lacking 2 electrons. Valency will be 2. Nitrogen, it is atomic number is 7. Configuration will be 2-5. Aluminium, 13, 2-8-3. Magnesium, 12, 2-8-2. Likewise, there are the atoms. Except these things, except these 6. All the atoms, they have incomplete outermost cell. So to complete their outermost cell, complete this valence cell, they attempt to get to attain a stable configuration. They combine with atoms. Now how they combine? Either by gaining, losing or sharing the electron. Now ion formation, how the ions are formed. We have known that if it is sodium, its atomic number is 11, means configuration is 2-8-1. To get 8 electrons in the outermost cell, it will tend to lose 1 electron, will form sodium ion. Now chlorine, it has 2-8-7, will have 1 electron, it will need 1 electron to complete its octet, will form negative ion. So ions are formed either by losing or gaining. So after forming this positive ion sodium plus this chloride ion, opposite charges attracts each other and forms a molecule of sodium chloride. So, ion formation, when an atom loses or gains electrons, it forms positive or negative charges because the balance of positive charge and negative charges becomes equal. Whatsoever will be the number of positive charge will be the number of negative charges. Hence, ions are charged particles which are formed due to the loss or gain of one or more electron by an atom. Here are some examples. These positive charges, sodium, potassium, magnesium, means all the metals lose electron and forms positive ions. They are called cations, while the nonmetals, they gain electrons and forms negative charges called anions. How do atoms combine? जैसे कोई बच्चा एक रोटी खाता है, उससे बड़ा वाला दो रोटी खाता है, बहुत बड़ा आदमी है तो तीन चार भी खा लेता है. According to their capacity, so different atoms have different valence electron and they have different valency. So the atoms combined with one other according to their combining capacity, which is known as your valency. So valency is the combining capacity of an atom of an element with atom of another element to form molecules. Ki what is now capacity, ki how much electrons it can lose or how much electrons it can gain or share, that is called your valency. For example, hydrogen has valency 1, oxygen has 2. Why? It will share or it will gain one electron to complete its duplet. Oxygen atomic number is 8, 2-6 is the configuration. It will gain 2 electrons or share 2 electrons, will have the valency 2. Nitrogen 7 is the atomic number. Configuration will be 2-5. 2 have 8 electrons in the outermost shell. 2-5 is the configuration. To have 3 electrons in the outermost shell, it needs 3 electrons. So 3 is the combining capacity. Aluminium has 13 configuration. So, not configuration, sorry. Atomic number. Configuration will be 2-8-3. To get 8 electrons in the outermost shell, it will lose 3 electrons. So its combining capacity, losing capacity is 3. Valency will be 3. Magnesium valency 2. Why? Its atomic number is 12. Configuration is 2-8-2. So these 2 electrons can be lost. So valency will be 2. Now, variable valency. What is variable valency? My dear students, now we had seen hydrogen has valency 1, oxygen valency 2, nitrogen has valency 3, aluminium has valency 3, magnesium valency 3. Likewise, calcium, its valency is 2. Chlorine, fluorine, bromine, iodine, they all have valency 1. So, all the elements, whether they are metals or non-metals, they have only one valency. Only one valency means here is one, only one. Here is valency 2, means only one valency showing. What is that valency 2? Here also only one valency, that is 3. Carbon, 4. Carbon has also only one valency, 4. But certain, some of the element shows valency more than one, as they are showing only one valency. But some elements like lead, silver, copper, iron, sometimes this silver shows valency 1 and this silver shows valency 2. This copper shows valency 1, sometimes it shows valency 2. Iron sometimes shows valency 2, sometimes it shows 3. So, certain element shows more than one valency. These elements are supposed to exhibit variable valency. For example, iron, copper, tin, lead, sulfur, phosphorus. Now, Suppose it is your copper, its atomic number is 29. What will be the electronic distribution? 2, 8, 18, 1. So in the outermost shell, it will have only one electron. So it will lose only one electron. So its valence, losing capacity is 1, valency will be 1. Sometimes what happens, my dear friends, just this is the penultimate cell, this is outermost cell. Here is your outermost cell has this much electron, only 1. Here it should be 18 electrons. But after gaining 17 electron, the 18th electron jumps into the next cell. Next cell means in the outermost cell. It will happen only from this cell, penultimate cell. It will not come on this cell. Only it will go on the outermost cell. So instead of 18, it will have only 17. And here, instead of having 1, now it will have 2 electrons. So its configuration will be now 2, 8, 70, 17, 2. This will lose 2 electrons. So its losing capacity will be 2, means valency will be 2. Now, if it is so, then this will be called cuprous, because lower valency, less valency is 1, higher is 2. So lower valency wala kahlaga cuprous. The atoms having the lower valency will be called us, cuprous. Likewise ferrous, cupric, or even we write copper 2, but this copper 2 is not acceptable. We should write copper Roman letter in bracket. Here cuprous or copper 1. This means this is the copper which have the valency 1. Then here same thing. In the case of metal exhibiting variable valency, we represent the lower valency by adding suffix us. Lower valency 1 agar hai to us, or 2 hai to ek, to the name of the metal, to represent the higher valency suffix ek. For example, metal iron has valency 2 and 3. For the lower valency 2, we write ferrous. And for the higher valence, we write 3. We write ferric for 3. ठीक है? इसको देख लेंगे. Then, one thing will be radical. Radical is what? Part of compound. Radical is what? Part of compound. For example, here is a compound, sodium chloride. Part of compound means sodium is made up of two parts. One part is sodium, another part is chlorine, means this is the first part and this one chlorine is the second part. If we see sodium, sodium is a metal, chlorine is a non-metal. Chlorine and sodium, how combines? So sodium lose one electron, it forms sodium ion. Chlorine gains one electron, it forms chloride ion. Opposite charges attracts each other and forms a compound. So all the metals form positive charges, means cation, and all the non-metals form negative charges. So they form positive cations are called positive radical and negative charges are called negative radicals. Or even these positive radicals are called basic radicals, and this is called acid radicals. All the metals are called basic radicals, and all the nonmetals or group of nonmetals are called acid radicals. But all these radicals combine together to form a compound. This is called your radical. As a whole, they combine together form a unit. A radical is an atom or maybe an element or a group of atoms of different elements which behave as a single unit with a positive charge on it. If you see here, the positively charged radicals are called basic radicals, like this. Except this one, ammonia, NH4 is called ammonia. Except ammonia, all the metals form positive charge, means basic radicals, and all the nonmetals or group of nonmetals, here is one atom of chlorine, two atoms of different, and here are more than two. So here are group of nonmetals, means they will form negative charges. So all the anions or negatively charged radicals, they form acid radicals. Basic radicals are also known as cation, and acid radicals are also known as anion. So my dear students, you should know these things. And what is the symbolic representation? We must know these things. So today we have come to an end of this chapter 4. Next day we will start new chapter 5, Language of Chemistry. See you, all the best, goodbye.